Hey, folks, we're going to get the House Retirement Committee meeting called to order. Representative Hill, first of all, are you feeling better?
Yes, sir. Thank you. Much, much better.
Good, good. Could you lead us in a word, please?
Yes, thank you. Let us pray. Our dear, kind Heavenly Father, as we come to you, we thank you, Lord, for another day that you've given us. We just pray, Lord, that we'd utilize this day that would be pleasing to you the way we do it. As King Solomon said, I'm just a man. I need your help, Lord. So we ask for your help and your guidance, that you would be pleased with what we do here, and it'd bring honor in thy name. In Jesus' name we pray and ask. Amen.
Thank you, Representative. Okay, we have one bill on the agenda today, House Bill 925. You should have that in your packets. Representative Sains.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We have House Bill 925, LC 432005. It was brought to my attention by, actually directly by my own Superior Court judge, Judge Robert Guy, which I don't know what his courtroom looks like, but I highly recommend his bar and hotel over in downtown St. Mary's. But this bill just takes away the prohibition on post-retirement benefits, on allowing their board of directors to look at it if they came in past 2009. So this just takes away that prohibition. It's a non-revenue retirement bill. Do you want to say any words?
Good afternoon. I'm Bert Guy. I'm a Superior Court judge in the Brunswick Circuit, and I appreciate Representative Sains bringing this bill on behalf of the Council of Superior Court Judges. Just wanted to tell you that this is, as he mentioned, is no fiscal impact, and if the trustees feel that a COLA is appropriate and sound, then this would authorize them to do that for those who have started service after 09. For the Superior Court judges who started their judicial service before that, they can already get a COLA. So it just creates a parity between all of the Superior Court judges. Thank you.
Thank you for that. So my guess is that this was probably added in either the 09 or 2010 session during the downturn to more or less shore up the system by reducing benefits. Am I correct in that saying that?
That is when it happened, yes. It was, I believe it was the 08 session effective January 1 of 09 is my recollection. July 1st of 09, excuse me.
Got it. Okay. Any questions from the committee? I think we have a letter of support from the Council of Superior Court Judges.
It came to the committee yesterday. Yes, sir.
Got it. And this has been certified as a non-fiscal bill.
Yes.
We've done it when we have
brought this before this committee in the past. We had a fiscal note done in the past, and it had no impact.
Got it. Okay. Number 25.
Mr. Chairman, at the proper time, I'd like to be recognized for a motion.
I'll recognize a motion.
I move that House Bill 925 do pass.
We have a do pass. Do we have a second? Any further discussion? I did have one piece of discussion. Can you tell me your funded level as of, say, June 30th of last year? What was that percentage?
I know that we were one of the best funded pensions in the country. We were over 20. It was over 20% overfunded what we needed.
Okay. Mr. Popman, do you want to address that real quick? Should be on.
Yes, sir. The JRS is about 106% funded as of the most recent valuation.
I wish they all were.
Me too.
Very good. That's very good news. We have a motion due pass. We have a second. Great financial position. I presume that's of June 30th of last year. 2020. Okay. All in favor of the motion due pass, say aye. All opposed. Aye. On Zoom.
I said aye.
Motion carries unanimously. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Be sure to fill out your rules form and bring it to me. And we'll move it forward. This meeting is adjourned. Thanks, everybody.